Hey guys, welcome to episode 9 of Twisted Nerd Podcast. I am your host, Robin. Sorry about the noise. I'm not going to restart this again because it's about the fourth time I've had to do this. My degus are over in the corner digging away and being noisy little things. So I apologize right off the bat for that. I want to thank all new and returning viewers. I also want to welcome Nicole, who introduced herself in the group. Hi, Nicole! I want to apologize for not podcasting last week. I just ended up not feeling like it. It was my birthday. That wasn't the primary reason. As the day wore on, I got to the point where there was more stuff going on because I went to the fabric store with my dad. And there's a bunch of stuff that happened. Not bad things, but I just didn't feel like doing it. And meh. So, yes, I am doing it today, and actually, I'm kind of glad I waited a week, because I did a ton of stuff this last week, so this episode should actually have a lot more content if I can actually slow down and talk at a normal speed. No guarantee on that. For whips, I actually got quite a bit done on my socks. They were my purse knitting, they are my purse knitting. And I actually got a lot done because there was, I can't remember, but I got, oh man, how much, let me reach for my ruler. I got about 3 1/4 inches done on the first sock. And I have about, because I do, before I start my toe decreases, I do for my sock, the feet of my socks, I do the fish lips kiss heel. So I measure from the toe of my sock. You can see it's relatively even. And I measure, I go until, I count the rows, but I go till it's 7 inches. Because my foot is 9 inches long, and that way it leaves me 2 inches to do the cuff, and I find when I do it like that, they really fit me, so I always do 2 inches shorter than the foot. I just started doing that with my parents' socks. So, I've got 2 inches left to go before I can start the heel, so with a little bit of luck, I can get that done this next 2 weeks. I'm just gonna move this up really quickly, or I will forget to do it. And the other thing, I also worked on this sock. I worked on the second one. I got the heel done, and I did, I think, a little bit of, I think I had like 5 or 6 rows left to go for the heel. But all I've done is the heel. I haven't started the other rows yet. I really want to get this sock done so I can cast on my Hermione's Everyday socks. Because, like I said in past videos, I really want to have those on my needles, like, established on my needles for Comic-Con. And then probably what I'll end up doing is bringing those, and if I still have these on the needles, I might bring these as well. Just so I have something to work on and something to keep my mind busy. I'm going to move this up because this is already broken. I kneeled on it, so I'm just going to try to keep that up there where it's safe. I did very little on this, but I will show you. This is my hitchhiker in my, oh, the socks are in a made by me crappy bag. This is in Addicted to Sock Knitting bag, and it's the Avengers, because Avengers. I have 12 teeth now. Like I said, I only worked on it a little bit. I would like to do some more on it, obviously, but yeah. So there it is. I got one tooth done. I'm just kind of slowly working my way on it. And if I can get, you know, I don't want to push myself, but maybe if I can get like a tooth done a week, which I know isn't a lot, but, you know, I'd be pretty happy with that. The other thing I started, and this is in my Silver Shed USA bag from Laura. And I love this bag. It's so cute. This is not done, but I've finished the square part of it. But I'm making lovies because, like I said, I have some friends who are having little ones. So there's that. And then these are done with the top, this kit. So I will be using this little head as the head of the lovey. I've started the second one, but I keep coming up with where, you know, you get thin sections like this, where like one of the strands is broken and there's a lot of them. Like, and you go further up and there's more, so I'm not sure. And there's another one, I can see it in the yarn. So I'm not really sure what I'm gonna do. If I'm gonna just use a different yarn and use the same head, I haven't really decided yet. That's kind of annoying, especially because it's the plan is to be used by a baby. So if it's something that, you know, if it's one of those toys that they end up loving and they cart around, I think it kind of go down really fast. My other whips are for the craft show I have coming up on April 9th. Pull the yarn. And I am working on some little sheep agates. I really like the color I used, I had some left over of this a couple years ago, and I used the leftovers to make some sheeps, and I loved it, so I got a ball. It's Red Heart Super Saver, and it's actually pretty soft for Red Heart, and because I love the way they looked, so I bought one ball of it specifically for agates. So there we go. That is all the whips I have right now. It's all the yarn, the knitting and crocheting whips I have right now. I have technically three UFOs this week, though technically it's three kinds, and one I have like eight of them, but I'm only gonna show you the one because they're all identical. But the first one I have done is so cute. I seriously love this. It is the Horsin' Around scarf, and I will look up really quickly who it's by. This scarf is by Joanne Grimm Thompson, and just, it is so cute. I absolutely love it. I love how it's been done. But what I did, because this is for a little girl, instead of doing just straight white in the mane and tail, little pie, when I did, I'm not gonna give too much away, but the pattern calls for a certain number of ties in the mane. So what I did was I did the amount required plus one pink one, just to kind of give it a little girly feel. And this one I just wrapped, you know, I think wrap five times. I can't remember how many wraps you're supposed to do, but you wrap however many times. So I'd wrap five times, do one wrap of pink, wrap five times, do a pink for this, just to kind of. And it's hard, the pink's kind of concentrated more to this side than to this side, but that's okay. I think this is so, so cute. And yeah, the ears don't like to stay too much. There it is. I love it. I'm just gonna pull the mane back so you can see the expression. I actually get all the mane back. That'd be lovely. He's kind of just like, oh my god. Looks like my horse on a daily basis. So, eh. Also started and finished a lovely little patch. This was my mom's birthday present. My mom's birthday was yesterday, so she already received this, but I had to steal it back so I could do the podcast. So now I can actually give this to her and she can keep it. Probably away from the border collie, because he saw it and he's like, new toy. It's like, no, that's not yours. So there he is. He's so cute. I did him in shades of green, obviously. And this pattern is by Susan Claudino. Can't believe I had to think about that. Like, I am obsessed with her patterns. I'm not even joking. And my last FO, one looks halfway decent. Here we go. Is my BMX agates. So I was told by a mom friend that, because I have not seen Big Hero 6. I'm sorry, please don't shoot me. And she said that the heart was really important. So, yeah, there's a little bit mess, and I have eight of these done, which is awesome. I actually have some spinning this week. Now, this is not the full single. What happened was, as I was spinning it, I had one more color to go, and I had a decent amount of that color, and because the fiber was starting to slide down on the shaft of the spindle, it was getting in my way, and it was pissing me off, and I didn't want to work on it anymore, so I'm like, you know what, I'm just gonna move the rest of the single onto one of these, and then when I'm done with the last color, I will rewind this onto a different bobbin, and then just spin it and attach it. So, I finished the black. I'll say that right now. You can see the black underneath, right there. And I did a little bit of the orange. And then let me see how this bag does for... Oh, that's pretty good. That's too fuzzy. So, I had to put a new leader on, because the leader I had on was a little history. So I started spinning up the orange, and it kind of looks a lot brighter than it actually is. It's kind of a pale orange. Yes, it's a little bit brighter, but it's fairly true to color. So I started that. And that's all that I have done for spinning. I did a little teeny tiny bit on... I did a little bit on this spindle, but not a lot. I'm probably gonna have to break it off and start over because it's starting to get a little full. I took, 2 days? And it had like a big sewing bee, so I took one day and cut out a bunch of stuff. And again, the majority of this is for friends who are having babies. I took a couple hours one day and looked online for simple sewing patterns for babies because I'm not really good at sewing yet. I'm still learning, so I'm sure that one lasts. So I found patterns for hats, burp cloth, which I think is really cute, and some bibs. So I want to do, so this is the first thing I did. This is a little baby hat, obviously. I want to do something with the hem, even though technically it doesn't need it because it is fleece, but I think probably what I'll do is I'll just tuck it under and do a little hem just to kind of neaten it up a little bit. But now my one friend is due in November, so this will probably be for her. One is due in August, so I probably won't do as much warmy things for her so much as, I shouldn't say that, because I probably still do warm things for her, but they'll probably obviously be in bigger sizes for her. And also, my sister has requested that I make some baby things for a friend of hers from work who was having a baby. So I have to do that. I'm going to do that as well. So, this one, I fully admit I'm not thrilled with because it looks really small. I still have to top stitch all these, so there is still an opening. I have to go through and top stitch, but I want to iron them out first. So I want to get a bunch done, then take a day to have an ironing party. So, this is it. I love this fabric. It's so cute. I can't remember if this fabric is from the thrift sale that I go to, like, biannually, or if it's from my pastor's mom. I can't remember off the top of my head. But, sorry about that. I got cut off. my camera's like, yep, I'm done. I want to record now. It's like, you're rude. So anyways, so this is it. It's I haven't done a snaps or anything, obviously, but it's so small. It'd be a good newborn size, according to my mother. I'm not around babies a ton, so I don't know these things. And I used a green fleece on the back. A lot of what I've used is remnants, because I get remnants. I always look for fleece, because I love fleece. It's awesome. And I look for fleece a lot. This is the next one. And what I did with the pattern was where these end is where the pattern for this one ends as well. But I wanted to make be able to have it be bigger. So when I cut it out, I just went up higher and went down. So this one, there we go, that's more accurate. And then I used a purple background, purple backing, purple fleece. Okay, I'm gonna show this one next. This one It's seriously my favorite. I'm gonna make another one for myself. Those of you who don't know, I want to do a hope chest. But I think it said, actually, I stopped the post. I want to do a hope chest, so I definitely want to make one of these for myself because it's awesome. But this is for my one friend specifically who likes this kind of stuff for her little boy. So what this actually is this is a character sheet I got at Value Village, and I got, not of this particular time, I think I got 3 Batman, 2 Iron Man, a Spider-Man, and just a bear one from Value Village. And seriously, if you guys have something like that, I think there's one in the US, I think it's called Savers, but from videos I've seen of people in Savers, I think it's the Value Village equivalent, or maybe Value Village is the Savers equivalent, I don't know. But for those of you in the States, if you can go and you can find like relatively good condition sheets, it's really cheaper. Like, because the ones I have, I think were about $3.99, $5, right in that area somewhere each. And it's really cheaper than going to, you know, a fabric store and getting a yard of fabric or this much for like $26, because licensed fabric is not cheap. But if you can find cheap sheets in really good condition, especially from thrift stores, it's really cheap, and I kind of like that. So there's that, and this is the background I used. Oh, and I have, actually, I'm not going to, 4 burp cloths. Now I have technically 1 more burp cloth and 1 more bib that I've cut out, but they're not sewn yet because I'm using them as templates. So the first burp cloth is this pink one, and it's really cute, and it's got ladybugs. So actually this might go to my sister's friend because she likes ladybugs. So there's purple background. And I love these because it's just like, you know, and I showed these to my, you know, my friends with kids or that have nieces and nephews that they see a lot. And it's like, okay, is this something that would work? And I said, yeah, absolutely. Because I wanted to check before I printed it off and went through all the work of making them if it wasn't going to work. But this is really awesome. And it's the fabric, even though it's cotton, it's pretty soft. And it's nice because it has the divot, the wow in here, for your shoulder. And I know, and it's comfortable, I think. It's that one. I have to make some more boy ones of these. Just that one. Because my one friend is for sure having a boy, one doesn't know yet. There's that one. And this, okay, this fleece is old as the hills. This is fleece that's, I think it's actually the same fleece I used for Bruno and She's a Puppy, though this isn't from one of her blankets. I think I saved like a section of it so I can make something from it, other than for her. So this is old fleece. I've had this fleece in my, this is deep stash. Well, I consider deep stash. And this one, which I love this fabric. Again, this I'm not sure if I got at the thrift sale or from my pastor's mom, because she gave me like, cause it was funny. I think when she gave it to me, she said, oh yeah, my mom has some fabric she wants. I said, okay, cool. You know, thank you. And I thought, okay, a box, I figured, you know, it was gonna be a small box. No, this thing was like this by like this, and it was full, it was huge. Like this massive box of fabric, and I'm like, that's a lot more than I thought, but thank you. So, this is the background. Or, the backing, I'm sorry, I can't talk, I can't English. I think I've been doing sign language too much. There's the back. And that is all as far as the baby items go. I also wanted to play around with doing spinning bags. So this is one of them. And I will, and the fabric, not this fabric, but there is fabric that I use that is part of my spoilers, but that's okay, I can show you anyways. So what I did was I got this really soft kind of silky, it's actually upholstery fabric, actually. And it's really nice and it's really slick. So I thought for the fiber to keep it from sticking. And I mean, you know, I've been pulling this out in and out, and it works really nice. It's a really nice fabric. So, this is my purse spinning. So this spindle, I always have in my bag with me. This is the spindle that's in here is the one that I showed you guys earlier. And I showed you them both earlier. This is my Highland Handmaids spindle. Actually, I still have yet to spin her fiber. I honestly can't, it sounds bad, but I can't wait to be done with this fiber so I can spin something else. I might actually cheat and go do something else just really small, just so I can kind of have a break from it. And then this is the other one I did. And it's just a wood grain, and it's the same lining. I would at some point let you go back and get some satin or silky fabric that's different kinds, but I just got black, because you know what, black goes with everything. And now this spindle, the one that's in here, is actually quite a bit longer than this spindle, because the bags are the same size, and they're both, okay, both the spindles are sitting at an angle. So one goes from there to there, and this one, if the top is here, the top is right there, so that's how much difference bigger it is. So this one is here to here. So it's, this one's a bigger spindle and it fits really, really well. And this one obviously has the bigger head round thing. I like to think I know what I'm doing, talking about, but I probably don't. So yeah, so they fit really well in those bags and I'm really happy with those. I did a fair bit on my secret cross stitch, however, you can't really see it because it is white on white, but, and I just, what did I lose? Oh. There you go. So, I've done all the white on this side, I'm starting to do the white here. And I think once I've done that, I'm going to go and do the other colors that are around it, on just in this, from like, this section over, I'm going to do the colors that are in here. Let's tuck you all in there. That's all done for cross stitch. It's not a lot. I just did this like a day or two after I did my last podcast, so I haven't done it for a couple of weeks. Like I said in Not All Who Wander, my dad and I went to the fabric store. Let's put it this way. I don't think my dad's going to go with me to the fabric store ever again. I think he wants to skin me. But I got... Now, this is from Fabricland. They were having a 50% off sale of basically everything, which included the bargain center. So I'm like, hey, Dad, why don't we go there? Because I can take $20 and get a ton of get a decent amount of fabric for really, really cheap. Because the bargain center, I think the highest price I've seen in the bargain center is $5, and everything would be half off, so it'd be so much cheaper. So, yeah, I think Dad wants to kill me. But so this is the only, ended up being the only fabric I got from the bargain center, and this is the fabric that I used for my bags that I showed you in my sewing section. And I got a yard of this, and this ended up becoming, this was $1.50. It was $3 regular. I should say regular because it was in the bargain center, but it was $3, and I got it for $1.50. Now, this is where I'm pretty sure my dad wanted to kill me. When I walked in, the bargain center is right at the very back of the building, so you have to go through like the rest of the store to get to it. And when I walked through, I spotted Star Wars fabric, and I stopped and had a quick look and then kept walking. Now, the thing is, because like I said earlier in the podcast, it is licensed fabric, so it is expensive. And so I looked at, so I had pulled out some fabric that I wanted from the bargain center, but I kept thinking I really would love to get some Star Wars fabric. So I wasn't sure what I wanted to do, if I wanted to, you know, forgo the bargain center fabric, I get Star Wars fabric. And I went and I looked and I was like, oh, like, you know, I don't know. And I went and he said, okay, well, go look. I'll stay with the cart, with the basket. You go look. So I went and looked. And I ended up deciding after a while to end up getting Star Wars fabric. So I kept this, because the whole point of me going is I really need to get some soft satiny fabric. So I kept the black because it was the cheapest out of the group, and it's black, it goes with anything. So then I hemmed and hawed about which fabric I wanted, because there's about, I think it was six different bolts of cotton, and there was 2 bolts of flannel plus 2 bolts of Star Trek flannel. And I was like, well, if I do it this way, I can get a bag. If I do this, I can make a bag. If I do this, I can make a blanket. You know, how much, and I was, you know, so how much is a mirror? How much is, or not how much. So I was like, you know, what size is this? You know, how many squares can I get out of this much fabric? And I think I probably spent a good 40 minutes doing this. And like I said, I think my mom was about to kill me, but the fabric was regular $26 a meter. So it's like, okay, let me rephrase that. The cotton was regular $26 a meter, and the flannel was regular $18 a meter, plus half off, plus I only got half a yard of each. So I ended up deciding on 2 flannel, the 2 Star Wars flannel, and 2 of, and I was originally going to get 1 of the cotton, but, because basically it was, do I get 4 flannel, do I get 2 cotton, you know, do I get 2 or 3 cotton, do I get 2 flannel and a cotton, you know, it was like the different combinations, I didn't know. So I'll show you the flannel. The flannel was fairly easy because there was only 2 Star Wars flannel. I got this one, which is the dark side, for those of you who don't see Star Wars, but dark side. And this is all Force Awakens. This isn't the original series. I think if there was that plus this, it would have made it 10 times worse, and I think it really would have killed me. So there's that. My plan with the flannel is to make a fandom blanket. So I want to see if I can get my hands on some flannel from my other fandoms and make a blanket. Or it's a ragtime blanket, I believe is what it's called. And there's this one, which is obviously the light side. So we have Chewie and Rey and BB-8 and Poe and Finn. I think that's all. I don't think they have anybody else, just those 5 people. Yeah. But so there's that one. I love it. It's so pretty and it's nice and soft. Now, the hard part was for the Star Wars is they had, I think, one of them, they had 3, the same pattern, but they had 3 different shades of it. They had another one they had 2 they had 2 of, they had one, something they had 1 of. So, it was, I ended up, this was the one that had 3 different shades of this material. And it went with this one, so I like this one a bit better. And again, this is obviously the light side, and we have BB-8 and Rey and Poe, Chewie, Finn, I'm gonna guess, I don't know if that's just, there's Millennium Falcon. I don't know if the X-Wing is supposed to be Poe's or if it's just a general generic X-Wing. I don't know. Oh, and it also has the resistance symbol. There's that one. And then I also have this fabric in my hands and I was in love with it and I couldn't decide what I wanted and I was like, and I probably spent probably a good chunk of the time I spent trying to decide which one of the 2 fabrics to get. I got cut off again, so I'm gonna try and get through these last 2 sections really fast. I have a craft show, like I said again earlier, I have a craft show coming up on April 9th. So probably I think a good chunk of what I work on for the next 2 weeks is going to be for said craft show. I think my next podcast is, my next podcast is the Friday before, so we shall see. I will try to podcast that day. I might end up podcasting the day earlier, or it might hold off, I don't know. But actually, I'm kind of glad I'm on this schedule now instead of the one I was on previously, because it means that my podcast doesn't fall on Comic-Con, so that way I don't have to worry about there not being a podcast that week. I can just carry on with my normal schedule. So I'm going to try and stick to the schedule. I think that's all I have as far as winter is coming. I'm just, again, doing the baby stuff. I'm going to keep working on that and get some stuff done for the craft show. That's about it. When my dad and my sister went up, I want to say north, but it's not technically north, for a doctor's appointment for my sister. And my dad has gotten into the habit of, if there's a Walmart in the area, he will stop and check and see if they have Funko Pops, or as he calls them, Jungle Pops. And my sister texted me and said, do you have such and such Funko Pop in this line? And I said, no, I don't. And it was 72, Star Wars 72, and I asked her, which one is it? And she said, it's someone called Poe Dameron. She hasn't seen the movie. She has never seen Star Wars. So I'm like, oh, awesome. Does he have a helmet on? Is he unmasked? And she's like, what? And I said, does he have a helmet on? She said, no, he doesn't. So and I realized, because I'd seen about a week or so earlier, that they had a couple of Walmart exclusives. Poe Dameron unmasked and Kylo Ren unmasked. And I was like, get him. And so they spent the rest of the time going, oh, that is hard enough to get him. And I'm like, excuse me. And I text her and I'm like, no, like, I will seriously pay one of you to get him. Just grab him for me, please. And Cream was like, oh, well, and she said, read between the lines. And I'm like, look, and she said, well, we'll have to wait until your birthday. And I'm like, I don't care if I have to wait until my birthday to get him. That doesn't bother me any, but at least tell me that you freaking have him. Because I was like pulling my hair out, and I'm pretty sure that mom, I think, was texting her on the side going, I think you're going to kill your sister. So anyways, on my birthday, I got this and I was very happy, and I still wanted to kill my sister, but. So this is obviously Walmart exclusive Poe Dameron, and I love that they even have his little, his cut under his eye, because I'm not going to say, because Sam Heaman runs in the movie, so, but I love that they have that, because that's actually accurate to the movie. But yeah, so there's Poe, and you have all of these guys on the back. I still want, like, all of them, especially, Captain Phasma, Chewie, CP3PO, BB-8, Rey, Finn, Poe, even the Stormtroopers. I want the Stormtroopers, the Snowtroopers, the Flametroopers. I want them all. They're cool. And then the other day, I wandered into our Walmart, my Walmart, whatever you want to call it, and because I needed to get a windbreaker, because my mom wanted me to have one for Comic-Con, so we wouldn't freeze like we did last year, because we kind of froze. And so my dad grabbed the hoodies for me, the jackets for me. He's like, these are necessities, I'm getting them. I'm like, okay. So he got them, and then he left, and I was like, and of course I didn't have any money on me except for my debit card, which I'd never use. And I was walking, and I'm like, what are the odds he's gone now? What are the odds that I'm, because I wanted to go check something in the craft section. And I'm like, oh, I'll check the toy section, because they're like literally right beside each other. And I said, what are the odds that they're going to have a Kylo Ren unmasked? Like, what are the odds? My dad's gone, he's out of the store now, what are the odds? And I walked over, guess what they had? Kylo Ren unmasked. And I was like, shit. And my phone had died, so I couldn't call my dad and say, Dad, I need some assistance. So I was like, okay, I've got my debit card. I'm pretty sure I remember my password, my passcode, my PIN code, and oh no, do I have enough in my account? So I grabbed, grabbed three other things that I will show you in a minute. And I had enough, so I was like, yes. So here is Kylo Ren unmasked. And he's so awesome. He's so cool. I love it. I'll show you the sign. And then this one on the back has Captain Ackbar, or Admiral Ackbar, which I want. Leia, Han, Nienib, and a couple other ones that I can't pronounce the names of. Varmic, I can probably say, but this one I can't say the name of. So there he is, and I was like, yes! My only doubt is I wish, because, the regular Kylo Ren is number 60. I wish he was, like, 61, so that way they could be that way, because I like displaying mine in numerical order within the sections. I was like, why couldn't they have done him as 61? That way they could be beside each other. But, oh, well, such is life. Actually, who is 61? BB-8 is 61. So then, last Christmas, my sister had gotten me Avengers Age of Ultron themed Hot Wheels. And after that, I became a little bit obsessed with the nerdy Hot Wheels. I have a box of them under my desk and a box of them over in the corner of my room. Mostly Star Wars, but every once in a while, I do have some regular Hot Wheels too, but a lot of the one I have is like the nerdy, so I have, just to give you an example. I have, like, the Star Wars thingamajigs, Star Wars planes, vehicles, whatever. So I spotted these at. I was just looking when I went to my end game when I got Kylo Ren. I was looking, just kind of wandering through the aisles, and I saw on an end cap, and they're just sitting there, like they weren't displayed. They were just kind of, they looked like they were haphazardly thrown on there, and they are Captain America specific ones. So this is the first one. And these, I will say, these will stay in the package just because I love how the cards look. So, this is a set of eight. So there's eight in the series, I have three of them. So I kind of want to see if I can find the rest. But there's that one, which, and this is a 1940 Ford Coupe. This one, as of right now, is my favorite, because it's Winter Soldier. I love them both. I love Captain America and Winter Soldier, but I love the car. The style of car. And there's the thing. And this is riveted. It says it's riveted, so I don't know if that's the type of car. I don't own my cars as much as I would like to. There's the top of it. I love it. And this is the last one I got. Oh, and this, the first one I showed you was 1 of 8. This one is 5 of 8, and then this one I'm gonna show you was 6 of 8. And this is a 57 Plymouth Fury. And it's like specifically the Avengers, but if you look at the back of the card, most of them are Captain America themed, with the exception of this one, which is the Avengers. The rest are either Bucky or Captain America themed. So there that is. This is so cool. So yeah, that is everything I have for total. So for the dark side, for Knitting and Crocheting. Yeah. So have a great 2 weeks, and I will see you on my next podcast. Bye, guys. Hi, Dad.
Hi. Talking to yourself again?
I'm doing my podcast! Rude.
Said I was coming back.
Talking to his dog. It tells me we're talking about it to myself.